Quality number one, take new risks. If you're walking on two legs right now, you took a risk. And at the time, it was a pretty bold one. Most likely, things didn't work out quite the way you wanted them to at first, but you didn't let that stop you from trying again and again and again until you got things right. And if you think walking is easy and not much risk, think about this. If I had you right here, in this studio, and asked you to attempt a handstand for me, would you? Probably not. I know because I've often done this with clients to demonstrate this point. You say you want something, but you're not willing to do what it takes to get it. One of my favorite music business stories is about violin virtuoso Itzhak Perlman. A woman walked up to him one day and said, "You play violin so beautifully. I'd give anything to be able to play like you do." He responded by simply saying, "No, you wouldn't." If you really want something, whether it be in music business or in life, you'll find a way to make it happen. And the risk or time commitment, no matter how great, won't be something you can't get around. Had this woman really wanted to play violin well, she'd already be well on her way to making that happen. Those who take the risk and make the sacrifices get the rewards. You get what you give. I encourage you to reevaluate risk in your life. Instead of concentrating on what could go wrong, put your energy behind what will happen when things go right. If I had you attempt a handstand, what's the worst that could happen? You'd fall, or maybe not even get your legs up more than a few inches off the ground. Neither one of those things is a big deal. And if I had you call a club because you needed more work for your act and wanted to pick up an extra gig, what's the worst that could happen? If you were professional on the phone and had done your research on the club ahead of time, the worst thing that could happen would be that you didn't get the gig. You wouldn't burn any bridges, and you'd be in no worse of a situation than if you didn't call. And even if you didn't get the gig, you'd at least know for sure that you wouldn't be playing rather than wonder if it could have been a possibility. Now, you may have absolutely no desire to do a handstand since, other than the physical benefits, there isn't much advantage to having that skill. But the advantage of being able to play a gig, make money, attract new fans, and otherwise further your career that comes from taking a few minutes to make a phone call is probably worth the risk.